A few billion kilometers from us is a small 478 kilogram probe hurtling through the Kuiper Belt at over 14 kilometers per second. And on July 14, 2015, it passed within 12,600 kilometers of the surface of everyone's favorite dwarf planet, Pluto, just 9 years, 5 months, and 25 days after launch, which means it got there pretty darn fast.
Three, two, one. We have ignition and liftoff of NASA's New Horizons spacecraft.
Riding on top of an Atlas V rocket, New Horizons' January 2006 launch holds the record for the highest speed launch from Earth, but that still wasn't fast enough to get the probe out to Pluto before Pluto's atmosphere condenses and freezes as the little guy moves further and further away from the sun. So in February of 2007, the probe whizzed by the planet Jupiter for a little bit of a speed boost. Now, I don't know if you know this, but Jupiter is not a rocket. So how did the planet give New Horizons the extra 3.8 gigajoules of energy the probe needed to get up to its new speed? Gravity and momentum. Specifically, a maneuver called a gravity assist.
But tech, if you fly close to an object and then fly away from it, the additional speed gain from gravitational attraction on the approach is lost whenever you leave.
Absolutely right. At least from Jupiter's point of view. Jupiter is big. About 318 times more massive than the Earth. And like all things with mass, it exerts a gravitational pull on objects nearby. As New Horizons approached Jupiter, it sped up because of the forward pull of Jupiter's gravity. Then, as it left, it slowed back down at the same rate because of the backwards pull from Jupiter's gravity. This balance meant that the net change in speed from gravity alone was zero. Though there was a change in direction and therefore a change in velocity. And this would have been all that happened. If Jupiter was the sun, everything inside of the solar system, including the Earth, Jupiter, Pluto, and New Horizons, is being pulled by the sun at a speed of 230 kilometers per second as the sun orbits the galactic center. But from our limited point of view, the sun appears to generally be stationary, with the planets and other objects moving around it. We call this the sun's inertial reference frame, and it's common for everything inside of the solar system, which means that if we were to try a gravity assist maneuver around the sun, we would get exactly the results that we had previously predicted, which is nothing would happen. But when we perform the maneuver around another object in the solar system, like say, Jupiter, we're able to change our speed and not just our velocity. Jupiter is traveling around its orbit at a speed of 47,051 kilometers per hour, or about 13 kilometers per second. And because of that, when we fly a probe like New Horizons nearby, we're able to steal some of Jupiter's momentum. The effect of gravity on the probe's approach and retreat is going to be the same, adding up to zero. But because Jupiter isn't sitting still, it's also going to pull the probe in the direction of the planet's motion. And importantly, this direction is the same on both the approach and the retreat. In general, the effect of a planet's motion on a passing probe like New Horizons depends on the relative angle of the probe's approach. New Horizons approached Jupiter perpendicular to the planet's motion at a speed of almost 19 kilometers per second. In the flyby, Jupiter gave the probe an additional perpendicular velocity of one planet's speed, or about 13 kilometers per second. When we add these two vectors together, we find a speed boost for New Horizons of about 4 kilometers per second and a direction change of about 35 degrees. And all of this was done with such precision that only two planned and minor course corrections were needed to get the probe within 12,600 kilometers of Pluto 8 years and 4.5 months later, which is the equivalent of firing a bullet from a spinning gun in Los Angeles and hitting a 20-meter moving target in New York City. Space is awesome. For Tech Laboratories, I'm Tech Adams, saying keep thinking, and thanks for watching. That's a refresh rate equivalent of 500 hertz. But on the other hand, when we blink, we black out our field of view for a third of a second, between 300 and 400 milliseconds, and our brain just filters it out. An alternating current looks like a wave, and has a frequency, an amplitude, and a phase when compared to other AC flows of the same frequency. All materials oppose the flow of charges, at least a little bit. This opposition, called resistance, is measured in ohms.